Hello there. After creating our first report in Web Intelligence, now let's go ahead and take a look at modifying it further by editing the query, applying filters, applying some sorts, and applying some conditional formatting on the report. Here's our BI Launchpad. First, let me go ahead and actually delete an additional report I have here. How you do that is right-click on the report, organize, and then say delete, or just select the report. Do it from your organize and delete. Okay, we go back to eFashion demo. To modify it, you right click on it and say modify. Here's our report. First thing, let me go ahead and rename this. So what I do is right click on the report and say rename. Instead of report one, let's say it's annual sales. Okay, now instead of report 1 year, which we had earlier, if you want to call it something else, you could just go in here and type whatever you like. Or let's say if you wanted the name to be same as the document name, you could go to the existing functions and say document name and click on OK. And then the document's name will automatically show up here. If you wanted to enhance it further to include the report name also here, you could just say plus, let's say, go to the miscellaneous functions here, and then you have an option here that says report name. Okay, double click on that, validate your function, looks good. See, it's come up here, the formula is correct. It would have been correct if I were to try and do something like this. So click on OK. So now you see it'll say eFashion demo and annual sales. Let me go ahead and save it. We'll now modify the report to include one more object in the report and maybe apply a filter. So I clicked on Edit from Data Access. So here's our query panel. We could also actually rename the query if we wanted. If we could just double click on it or right click on it and say rename. Okay, let us put a filter on the year. So what we're going to do is drag in year into the query filters, and instead of typing in a prompt and I mean typing in a value and running the report every time for a particular year, let us go ahead and put in a prompt. So what this will do is every time the report is run, the user will be prompted to enter the years for which he wants to run the report. Let us also go into the store class here and double click on store name, which will bring the store name into my query. Now let's run the query. Okay, let's select all the 3 years for now, and all the data is going to be available now. You do see that even though we select a store year name, it's not available in your report. So let's drag in the store name after the city. Let's go ahead and remove this break that we added earlier. So you go to report element and just click on break or say remove break. Now, by default, your report, it is sorted on the first column. So in this case, it's sorted by year. If you wanted to sort it on some other column, you just click on the column name and then go to analysis and then click on sort. Again, there are multiple options available for sorting, ascending and descending also. Now, if you want to add more sorts, more columns for your sorting, let's say you wanted to sort by city also, you can now click on city and say sort, or you could just go to manage sorts and you could click on add and select city. From here also you have the option of selecting ascending or descending, and you could also order the sorts. Like if you wanted your report to be first sorted by city and then by state, you would just select city and drag it up by clicking on this button here. So let's go ahead and click OK now. So you see now it's sorted by state and city. Now let's say we wanted to apply some kind of alerters to our report. Looking at this sample data, let's say we wanted to alert in red if we did see a sales of less than $250,000 in any of the stores. What we do in such cases is go to analysis, go to the conditional tab, create a new rule. Let's call this new rule sales alert. In the sales content here, select your sales revenue and say if it's less than 250K, then, I mean, by default it's red, so I'm going to leave it as red. If it's less than 250K, display the cell contents in red. Now the rule has not yet been applied on any of the cells, so let's go ahead and apply it on sales revenue. So we go to formatting rules and then select sales alert, and also let me do it on the store name. So if you scroll down here, you'll see that when it's less than 250K, it's showing up in red. If we also wanted to add more rules here, we could do so. Let's take a look at the sample data. Let's say we want to display something in green, or the store name and revenue in green, if it goes above, let's say, 1.9 million. In that case, we would go back to format rule, go to manage rules, go back to the sales alert, click on edit, add a condition here. Actually, sorry, not there. I have to click on add year and say if my sales revenue is greater than 1,900,000. Okay. In this case, you see the format's going to be green. So let me click on OK. Click on OK here again. And in your report, you will see that, you know, when it's greater than 1.9 million, it's showing up as 9. If I were to go back and change my rule to change the values again to something smaller, let's say in this case instead of 1.9, I just wanted to say 1 million, and this one, let's say 500K. Click on OK. You'll see more values in green and red. When it's less than 500K, it's in red, and when it's more than a million, it's in green. So, yep, that's a look at applying conditional alerting on your data. I'll try and continue further in my next tutorial. Hope this was helpful, and thank you very much for watching.